Courteney Cox dissolved all of her fillers. This was between 2015 and 17, and I have a picture of both before dissolving and after dissolving. We're going to look today at the pictures. We're going to look at what she did, why she did. I'm going to talk to you about dissolving, so many questions on that. And then I'm going to tell you what you can do to avoid that look. What did she miss? What could she have done differently to avoid that look in the first place? Let's run through it. First of all, let's talk about why people do what they do. Let's look at her picture. If we look here, 2015, you can see fuller cheeks, the under eye is full, and there's lip fullness. People always want to fill that nasolabial fold, but look in that area for her. You can see she doesn't have a deep fold, but it looks unnatural, like there's a heaviness above it. Why do people do that and overfill the front of the face? Two really good reasons for it. Number one, it's in the window. So when people come into my clinic, they're spending money. Let's say they spend a couple thousand dollars and they say, hey, they go home, look in the mirror, I see it, I like it, I can see where you did my treatment. But they're missing the frame of the face where it looks very natural to do work on. It looks unnatural in the window, which is what they look at when you go home in the mirror and determine, did I get my money's worth? And that's why people fill the cheeks, the nasal folds, the edge of the mouth, and the lips, because they see it. But what does everyone else see? And what did Courteney say? I looked unnatural. I didn't move properly. I need to move to see how my face actually works and looks when I'm in a natural state as opposed to a filled state. And the people around her noticed, and she said it looked better in life than in pictures. The second reason people fill the front of the cheek so much is to make the under eye look better. So if you're really full here, it stretches the tissue out and it fills the under eye, the tear trough, or that baggy under eye look, or under eye hollow or dark circle. So people put too much in the front. Those are the two reasons that commonly it gets overfilled. Now if we look at her picture as well, look at her lips. There's more lip volume in her filler picture from 2015 then in the current one from 2017. Granted, in the picture on the right, the latest one, she's smiling, so you lose lip volume when you smile, but no doubt she had some lip fillers there. Now, she said she had it dissolved. That means she must have had hyaluronic acid fillers. Those are the ones that can be dissolved with hyaluronidase. Most commonly, we use Hylenex now. Here's the thing. And I've dissolved a lot of fillers in the day, and of course, I've dissolved some of my own at times where I didn't like the look. So I have a lot of experience with the non-recombinant DNA or the older style of dissolver and the newer ones, all kinds of different ones over 20 years. Even though you put dissolver in, you don't know that you've removed it all. So in the after picture, almost guaranteed there's still filler there, and she looks fabulous. But it's not an all natural look like one might say. If you do an MRI study here, almost for certain, even if you flooded the face with 1,000 units of Hylenex, there's still some filler there. It's just less than before. So she overdid it in the picture from 2015, removed likely some of it, and there's 2017. And she looks fabulous even today, but understand, it's not a fully natural look in all likelihood because you just can't get rid of all the fillers. Now, if you see it and you keep dissolving over many sessions, you can certainly get rid of almost all of it. But understand, hyaluronic acid fillers have been found behind the orbital septum in the eye. They migrate, they move around. So to think you just go in and dissolve it and you're 100% filler free, it's highly unlikely. So you're seeing some filler, just not all of it. So how do we avoid this look to start with so you don't have to go through the painful process of dissolving? Meaning, it's not painful, it stings a little bit, but the painful part is for most people where money's a concern, they may have spent $10,000 or $20,000 on filler and then you're getting it dissolved. You pay to get it put in and you're paying to have it removed because it was overdone. And as she said, builds up gradually over time till you see a picture one day and you go, whoa, I don't like what I look like. What was missed here? The more natural treatments. And I'm thinking of three in particular. Number one, of course, platelet-rich fiber in your own blood products. There's many ways to use it. And even in gel form now, we have all natural type of fillers. Number two, biostimulators, PLLA, poly-L-lactic acid biostimulators. They're 50 microns, very small in size. They are injected. I use a lot of these. They stimulate your own body to build collagen around them. Then they leave the body. And it's collagen and elastin that loss that makes us look old. And that's exactly what biostimulators and PRF help build. And it does not give that filler look unless you overdo it intentionally. It just makes people look younger. It wakes up the collagen, the elastin. It decreases your MMPs, or all the collagenases, the things that break up your collagen, so that you get a beautiful glow to your skin as well. I use Sculptor, I have it in my face, and 90% plus of my patients have Sculptor and PRF combinations in their face. A very nice look overall for most people. And that is something that is not what we consider a filler. The third thing is, don't discount PDO threads. Particularly here, I'm thinking of smooth threads, not the lifting threads, but the collagen building threads. They don't give a filler look. They don't have the risk of arterial occlusion, necrosis, and all those problems that fillers have. And they go away on their own and leave your own body's collagen in its wake. So PDO lasts for about 3 to 5 months in the body, goes away totally, and many people have had PDO already, polydioxinone, it's in sutures. So people who've had any type of surgery have likely had dissolvable sutures placed. It's something people have had already, and it's a more natural solution than filling the face to try and get that lift. There are other treatments to do, but those would be the accepted treatments that people coming in for fillers would say, oh, instead of the filler, I'll do biostimulators, I'll do PRF, I'll do threads. I probably already had PDO in my body, and it would avoid this look. I want to know what you think of this filler look. Did Courteney do the right thing by dissolving some of her filler? I put a complete playlist up here on hyaluronic acid fillers, and one down here on Sculptra, so that you can learn more about these procedures, keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.